الصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين وبعد. So inshallah ta'ala, my dear brothers and sisters, we continue with the tafsir of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are doing the tafsir Ibn Kathir, the abridged copy of the tafsir of the Quran. We started last time, or last Saturday, we started with Surah Al-Fil, the Surah of the Elephant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he revealed that Surah as a reminder to the people of Quraysh. Before we study Surah Quraysh, we study Surah Quraysh and we said this Surah is related to Surah Al-Fil. Why? Because Allah always reminding the tribe of Quraysh and the people of Mecca, the one that was the people, the tribe who used to take care of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah remind them about what? By His protection to this house, to this sacred house, which is Al-Bayt al-Haram, the Kaaba, the house of Allah that was built by Ibrahim alayhi salam. And this surah, Surah Al-Fil, is a surah that was revealed in Mecca. We're just going to, inshallah ta'ala, read it and then mention what we said last time briefly, and then we continue with our tafsir. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, ألم تر كيف فعل ربك لأصحاب الفيل, ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل, وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل, ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل, فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the meaning of this surah briefly, before we started the reminding about the tafsir of Ibn Kathir, he said, you didn't see how your Lord did with the people of the elephant. Allah said, أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَضْرِيلٍ. He didn't make that evil planning in the lost. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلٍ. And then he said to them, to push them away, طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلٍ, a group of a huge amount of birds, special birds, in a huge number, with groups. تَرْمِيهِمْ بِهِجَارَةٍ مِنْ سِجِّيلٍ. He throw on them with the stones from سِجِّيلٍ. And we're going to mention what's the meaning of سِجِّيلٍ. فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ. And Allah made them as عَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ, which is like the herb that the hay that is being eaten by the animal, and then after that he threw it in as a stools in the ground. So Allah made them like that. So this is briefly the meaning of this part. We said Ibn Kathir alayhi rahmatullah said that these are from the bounty and the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah bestowed on the people of Quraysh. Even they were a disbeliever, even they were not worshipping Allah, but Allah gave victory to them against Abraha. And then we said that Abraha, he was the king from Abyssinia, that he decided to go with a big army and leading, that army is led by a big elephant. And we stopped in that point, which is when the group of the army comes to the Mecca or to the Kaaba to destroy the Kaaba. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he stopped them. He stopped those people and destroyed them. We arrived to the point that we said that the Ibrahim, he came to the Kaaba and then he brought with him a big army with a big elephant that no one saw like him. The name of that elephant is Mahmud. He said, وَكَانَ قَدْ بَعَثَهُ إِلَيْهِ النَّجَاشِي مَلِكُ الْحَبَشَةِ لِذَلِكَ. And then that elephant was sent from Abyssinia, from the king of Al-Najashi, from Abyssinia, the king of Abyssinia, for that purpose. وَيُقَالُ, and then he was said, كَانَ مَعَهُ أَيْضًا ثَمَانِيَةُ أَفْيَالٍ. And he was said that it was with him 8 elephants, not one. And also it was said that it was 12 elephants. some of the same that were elevated. All this to destroy the Kaaba and to make chain in this elephant and to tie it to the pillars of the Kaaba, and then the elephant will destroy the Kaaba by doing that and destroy the Kaaba for total. And then after that, when the Arabs heard about him, so they were upset. That because of that, so they decided to face the army of Abraham. They decided to face the army of Abraham and to push him away. One of the tribe of the Arab used to be from the people of Yemen. A man from the people of Yemen, used to be from the honorable tribe, and by the name of Dhu Nafar. By the name of Dhu Nafar. So he called his people and he decided to face Abraham, and they went to declare war against Abraham and to push him away from the house of Allah. So they obeyed him and he went to fight with Abraham, but Abraham, he overcome them. He overcome just because Allah want this to happen for certain reason that Allah subhanahu will destroy the army of Abraham. So he overcome them and he takes Dhu Nafar as a hostage. He takes Dhu Nafar as a hostage, and then after that he took him with him, and then he let him go. When Abraham with his army, they passed by a land called Khut'am, which is a tribe from the tribe of the Arab in the Arabian Peninsula. So one of the Arabs, honorable Arabs by the name of Nafil ibn Habib al-Khat'ami, from his people, so which is Shahran and Nahis, two tribes, so they fight also against Abraham. But again, Abraham, he defeated them. And then he take Nafil ibn Habib as a hostage. And then he want to kill him, and after that, he forgive him. After that, he took him with him to use him as a guide in the Arabian Peninsula. When he arrived to the land of Ta'if, so Ta'if is 80 kilometers from the Kaaba. So when he arrived to the land of Ta'if, so his people, the people of the tribe of Ta'if, Thaqif, so they deal with Abraham, they make a deal with him, and to not to touch their house, because they have their own house, which is the house of worship, which is not the Kaaba, but in it there is a god that they used to worship by the name of Allat. So they make a deal with him, do not touch our god, do not touch our house of worship, and then we let you go. And because of that, Abraham, he was generous with them, and then descended with him Abaragal in Dalila. So descended with him Abaragal, a man by Abaragal, which is as a guide, to guide him to the Kaaba. When Ibrahim, he arrived to a location called to Al-Maghmas, which is close to Mecca. So he settled there, and then when he set up there, so his army, so they went and attacked like mini camels that were in the area for the people of Mecca. And then they took it. And then in that group of camel, there used to be 200 camel for Abdul Muttalib. And all of us, we know who is Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib is the grandfather of Rasulullah. So all this is before Rasulullah was born. So he was in that group of camels, 200 camels for Abdul Muttalib. And the one who attacked this group of camel, it was by the order of Abraham. And then this man who attacked him used to be by the name of Al-Aswad ibn Maqsud. And then because of that, the Arabs, they were blaming him and saying poem about him. And then after that, when Abraham, he arrived to that location, he sent a man by the name of Hunata al-Humayri to Mecca. He sent him to Mecca. And then he told him to bring him the the high position people of Mecca to deal with them. And he wanted to say something to them. And he told him to tell them that the King Abraham, he didn't come to kill them, but he just wants to destroy the Kaaba. He will kill you if you stop him to destroy the Kaaba. So then Hunaka, he came to Mecca, and then he told about Abdul Muttalib ibn Hashim, وَبَلَّغَهُ مِنْ إِعَانِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ قَالَ. And then after that, he met with Abdul Muttalib, which is the grandfather of Rasulullah, and then he told him the message from Ibrahim, that we didn't come to fight with you, but we came only to destroy the Kaaba. But if you stop us, you try to fight with us, we will fight with you. فَقَالَ لَهُ عَبْدُ الْمُطَّلِبِ. So then Abdul Muttalib, he said to him, by Allah, we don't want to declare war against Ibrahim, and we have no power to fight with him. It's a big army with elephant. But he said, this is the house of Allah, the sacred house of Allah, and this is the house of his best friend Ibrahim alayhi salam. If Allah wants to stop them, if Allah stops them to do that, so then it is his house and his sacred house. And then if Allah wants this house to be destroyed, it will be destroyed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one who's able to do that, and then we have no power to fight against Abraham. And then Hanata, which is that man, the messenger from Abraham, he said to him, so then came with me to him, meaning Abdul Muttalib. So he went, like Abdul Muttalib, to go and meet with Abraham. He went with him, and then when Abraham saw him, so Abdul Muttalib, and Abdul Muttalib used to be very strong and tall man, and he has like respect when someone see him. So then Ibrahim, when he saw him, he respected him. And then he went down from his throne. So he went down because the king used to be, they made for them like a bed and a throne and they sit in it. And they are higher than people. So when Ibrahim saw Abdul Muttalib, so he went down to meet with him. And then he sat with him like on the carpet. And then he talked to his translator, which is the man that speaks Arabic, say to him, what do you want? Ibrahim saying to Abdul Muttalib, what do you want? What do you need? فَقَالَ لِلْتُرْجُمَانِ. And the Turjuman, Abdul Muttalib, he said to him, my need that I want the king to return back my 200 camel to me. That's it. That's what Abdul Muttalib said. And then فَقَالَ إِبْرَهَمْ لِتُرْجُمَانِ. Then Ibrahim said to the translator, say to him, you were in my, like in my heart, like I thought that you, I was so amazed by your appearance. And then because of that, I kind of respect you. He said to him, but now, like you are, I look at you down because what you said right now. He said, you talking to me about 200 camel that I took it from you, and you leave and you don't talk about the house which is your religion and the religion of your father and grandfather. Then I came to destroy it. I come to destroy, and then you don't talk about it to me. And then Abdul Muttalib, he said to him, Inni ana Rabbul Ibn, which means, I am the Lord of the camels. He said to him. And then he said, Wa inna lil bayti rabban sayamna'u. And for the house, which is the Kaaba, it has a Lord that he will defend it. So now that's a famous saying of Abdul Muttalib. And then he said, Ibrahim, ma kana yamtani'a minni. He said, he will not be able to stop me to destroy the Kaaba. Meaning, he meant by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Abdul Muttalib, he said clearly, simply, anta wa das, you and what do you want to do? If you can do it, so then do it. Wa yuqalu, and then it was said, ذهب مع عبد المطلب جماعة من أشراف العرب فعرضوا على إبراهيم ثلث أموال تهامة على أن يرجع إلى البيت. And he was said that a group of people, they went with Abdul Muttalib, that's another saying. They went to Ibrahim and then they make a deal with him that they will give him the third of the wealth of the tribe of Tuhama, big tribe. Now, with the condition that he go back and he doesn't destroy the Kaaba. And then Ibrahim, he refused that, and then he returned back to Abdul Muttalib, his camel. And then Abdul Muttalib, he went back to Quraysh, and then he commanded them to exit from the Mecca, to get away from Mecca, the village of Mecca. وَتَحَصْتُمْ فِي رُؤُوسِ الْجِبَالِ, and he wanted them to hide in the peak of the mountains. تَخَوُّفًا عَلَيْهِمْ مَعَرَةِ الْجَيْشِ, like out of fear that the army will harm them or they will kill them. ثُمَّ قَامَ عَبْدُ الْمُطَّلِبِ فَأَخَذَ بِحَلَقَةِ بَابِ الْكَعْبَةِ. Before he leave Abdul Muttalib, the Kaaba, he took the necklace. And there is a big necklace on the door of the Kaaba. So he took it by his hand and then he said, وَقَامَ مَعَهُ نَفَرٌ مِنْ قُرَيْشِ, and a group of people of Quraysh, they were with him. يَدْعُونَ اللَّهَ, they were making dua to Allah. Okay, now, the tribe of Quraysh, they are kuffar. But they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they worship with Allah partners. At that point, they were making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you know, the Lord of the house, which is the Lord of the Kaaba, is Allah. Nor Hubal and Sunsu. Hubal and other gods that we used to worship, they, like Hubal used to be called the god of war. Okay? Like the Roman, the god of love, the god of something. The Arab used to be doing the same. So those gods, so they are different. But they make them partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is their disbelief, the shirk. But in that situation, they were calling Allah, they were making dua to Allah to support them from against Abraha and his army. And then Abdul Muttalib, he said, وَهُوَ أَخِذٌ بِحَلَقَةِ بَابِ الْكَعْبَةِ, he said, لا هم إن المرأة يمنع رحله فاصنع حلالك لا يغلبن صليبهم ومحالهم غدوا محالك. No, here it's a poem, like Abdul Muttalib, he was saying, talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, like, a man, a just a person, he can, like, defend his camel, which he's talking about him, like, he defended his camel. And then he's asking dua to Allah to defend his house, which is to. And then he said, let their cross, because those people used to be Christian. We know that the people of Abraha used to be Christian. So that's the one of the story of Ashab al-Fil, which is the what happened at the time that Ibn Kathir mentioned. He mentioned after that, قال Ibn Ishaq. He said, Ibn Ishaq. He said, ثم أرسل عبد المطلب حلقة الباب ثم خرجوا إلى رؤوس الجبال. He said that عبد المطلب, he released the necklace of the door of the Kaaba, and then he went to the head of the mountains. And he said, like Muqatil ibn Sulaiman, he mentioned that he left the house, close to the house, 100 camels. He left it 100 camels. مقلبة لعل بعض الجيش ينال منها شيئا بغير حق فينتقم الله منه. The Arab used to have to offer what they call it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like we offer in the day of Eid, we offer the lamb or a camel or whatever, or a cow. So it's the same thing. They used to put, like, close to the Kaaba, مقلده, which means they put in their neck something as a sign, this is for Allah, no one touch. Okay? So this is, they used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they left 100 camel. Okay? So maybe if they touch it, because this is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so then Allah will revenge on them and he will defend his house. This is their belief. And then he said, لعل بعض الجيش, some of the army will attack it, and then Allah will revenge and he will destroy them. فلما أصبح أبرهة تهيأ لدخول مكة وهيأ في له. Then in the morning, Abraha prepared himself in the morning and he prepared the elephant and فيله وكان اسمه محمودا. That elephant used by the name Mahmud. And then he surprised his army and then he wanted to the Kaaba to destroy it. When he directed the elephant to the Kaaba, going to the Kaaba. So now Nafil ibn Habib. Now Nafil ibn Habib is from the Khut'um, which is a tribe that we mentioned before, and he took him as a prisoner. And he was at the same time a guide. But he still believed that Kaaba should not be destroyed. So now Nafil ibn Habib, what he said, he stood up beside the elephant and then he took his ear. And then he said in his ear, he said, "Ubruk محمود أو ارجع راشدا من حيث جئت فإنك في بلد الله الحرام ثم أرسل أذنه فبارك فيه." He said, "Ubruk Mahmud," meaning sit down. You see, when we have a camel or a cow or that elephant, when you sit on the ground, we call it in Arabic baraka. It's not baraka, but baraka, the verb baraka yabruku. He commanded him to sit down on the ground. He said, "Ubruk Mahmud," calling him by his name, "or go back from the location where you came from. Indeed, you are in the land of Allah, the sacred land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, baladillah al-haram, which is the Mecca and the surrounding of Mecca." Thumma arsala udhunahu fabarat, and then he released his ears, and then the elephant, he sat down on the ground. And then after that, he said, وَخَرَجَ نَفِيلُ بْنُ حَبِيدٍ يَشْتَدُّ حَتَّى أَصْعَدَ فِي الْجَبَلِ. And then, نَفِيلُ بْنُ حَبِيدٍ, so he escaped and ran away till he climbed the mountains. وَضَرَبُ الْفِيلِ يَقُومَ فَأَذَى. And then he started hitting the elephant to stand up, to continue, like to destroy the Kaaba, but he refused. فَضَرَبُوا فِي رَأْسِهِ بِالطَّبْرَزِينِ وَأَدْخَلُوا مَحَاجِنَ لَهُمْ فِي مُرَاقِهِ فَبَزَغُوهُ بِهَا لِيَقُمْ فَأَذَى. So they were using all tools, like to pick him and to harm him, to excite him, and then he refused to stand up. فَوَجَّهُوهُ رَاجِعًا إِلَى الْيَمَنِ فَقَامَ يُهَرْمِنُ. So then they direct him to Yemen, which is the opposite direction of the Kaaba. So what the elephant did? So then he stood up and then he ran away. After that, وَوَجَّهُوهُ إِلَى الشَّامِ فَفَعَلَ مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ. And he directed him toward Al-Sham. And then he did the same thing, which means he runs faster to that direction. وَوَجَّهُوهُ إِلَى الْمَشْرِقِ فَعَلَ مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ. And he directed him to the east, he did the same thing. وَوَجَّهُوهُ إِلَى مَكَّةَ فَبَرَكَ. So they direct him to the Mecca again. So what he did, he sat down on the ground. And then he said, وَأَرْسَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا مِنَ الْبَحْرِ أَمْثَالُ الْخَطَاطِيفِ وَالْبِلْسَانِ مَعَ كُلِّ طَائِرٍ مِنْهَا ثَلَاثَةُ أَحْجَارٍ يَحْمِلُهَا حَجَرٌ فِي مِنْقَارِهِ وَحَجَرَانِ فِي رِجْلَيْهِ أَمْثَالَ الْحُمُّسِ وَالْعَدَسِ وَلَا يُصِيبُ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا إِلَّا هَلَكَ. He said that Ibn Kathir, at the time, Ibn Ishaq, Allah sent a lot, big amount of birds from the sea. From the sea, it could be maybe the Red Sea. But from the sea, they came from the sea. These birds, with every bird of them, three stones, one in his back and two in both legs, both feet. And then he said, the lentil and the chickpea, the size of the lentil and chickpea. That's what he said. وَلَا يُصِيبُ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا هَلَكَ. Now these stones, imagine, it comes with a huge amount, million of it, but comes like rain. But they are stones, very hard stones. So he said, no one will be, that stone will touch him, except he will be killed. And he said, وَلَيْسَ كُلُّهُمْ أَصَابًا. But not all of them, they were touched by these stones. وَخَرَجُوا هَارِبِينَ يَبْتَدِرُونَ الطَّرِيقِ ويسألون عن نفيل يدلهم على الطريق. So when this happened to them, the stones falling down from the sky on them, so they ran away and they were asking about Nafil to what? Because he was their guide. And then, but Nafil, he was on the mountain with the people of Quraysh and وعرب الحجاج يقولون ماذا أنزل الله بأصحاب الفيل من النقمة. And the Arabs, all of them, they were looking at the people of the elephant, what Allah, he punished them with. And then, because of that, Nafil used to say one poem, the poem, it's in Arabic here. He said, وقال عطاء بن ياسر وغيره. He said, عطاء بن ياسر وغيره, and ref, ليس كلهم أصابه العذاب في الساعة الظالمة. He said, not all of them, they died and the punishment, the torment of Allah happened to them at the time. بل منهم من هلك سريعا. Some of them, they died right on the spot. ومنهم من جعل يتساقط عضوا عضوا وهم هاربون. And some of them, they use their parts, their body parts used to be falling down part by part while they are escaping. وكان إبراهيم ممن تساقط عضوا عضوا حتى مات ببلاد خثعم. He said, and Abraha, he used to be from the people who their body parts were falling down from their body, like the hands and then the foot and so on. He said, till he died in the earth of Khath'am as mentioned. وقال ابن إسحاق, Ibn Ishaq now he said, so they went out, falling down in every way. وَيَهْلَكُونَ عَلَى كُلِّ مَنْهَلْ. While they are running away, they are dying. وَأُصِيبَ أَبْرَهَةُ فِي جَسَدِهِ. And Abraha, he was touched in his body by these stones. وَخَرَجُوا بِهِ مَعَهُمْ يَسْقُطُ أَنْمُلَةً أَنْمُلَةً حَتَّى قَدِمُوا بِهِ صَنْعَةً. Now, that's another saying about Abraha. Like his body part were going part by part. And he said, he took him till he arrived to Sana'a, which is his city that he conquered. And then he said, وَهُوَ مِثْلُ فَرْخِ الطَّائِرِ. And he became like a bird, like this baby bird. فَمَا مَاتَ حَتَّى صَدَعَ صَدْرُهُ عَنْ قَلْبِهِ فِيمَا يَزْعُمُونَ. He didn't die till his heart get out from his chest, as they were pretending. He said, Ibn Ishaq, فَلَمَّا بَعَثَ اللَّهُ مُحَمَّدًا كَانَ فِيمَا يعد به على قريش من نعمته عليهم وفضله ما رد عنهم من أمر الحبشة لبقاء أمرهم ومدته. قال ابن إسحاق, he said, when Allah sent after that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, so which was after Allah revealed that surah, because he reminded the people of Quraysh for his bounty and his favor on them, and then push away the people of Habasha because he stayed and he made them alive. So because of that, Allah said, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ كَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَضْلِيلٍ وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلَ تَرْمِيهِمْ بِحِجَارَةٍ مِنْ سِجِيلٍ فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ لِإِيلَافِ قُرَيْشٍ إِيلَافِهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. So both surahs, Al-Fil and Quraysh. He said the reason of the revelation is it's the story of the people of the elephant. Allah reminded the people of Quraysh about his favor when he pushed away the people of Ibrahim. Ibn Hisham, alayhi rahmatullah, he said, Al-Ababi. Now he's going, if you can hear, with the explanation of the word. What's the meaning of Al-Ababi? فَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيل. He sent to them, on them, a bird that are Ababil. He said, Al-Ababilu Al-Jama'at. The groups. Ababil, had the groups. وَلَمْ تَتَكَلَّمِ الْعَرَبِ بِوَاحِدًا. He said, وَأَمَّا السِّجِّيلُ فَأَخْبَرَنِ يُونُسُ النَّحْوِ وَأَبُو عُبَيْدَةَ أَنَّهُ عِنْدَ الْعَرَبِ الشَّدِيدِ الصُّلْبِ. السِّجِّيلُ, which means بِحِجَارَةٍ مِنْ سِجِّيلٍ, that the bird, they were holding stones from Sijjil. He said, what is a Sijjil? A Sijjil means the hard one. The hard one, that's very hard one. The tough and the hard one at the same time. قال وذكر المفسرون أنهما كلمتان بالفارسية جعلتهما العرب كلمة واحدة. He said that it was said that some مفسرين that he said they are two Persian words, سجين, and they are combined, but the Arab made them one word. That is سنجن وجلد. سنجن وجلد meaning يعني بالسنج الحجر والجل الطين. Meaning that سنجن يقول الحجارة من هذين الجنسين الحجر والطين. Now سجين, that's one of the same مفسرين. This he said this is from the Persian language سجين, سنج, and جل means from stones and like the mud, the hard mud. قال والعصف, he said العصف فجعلهم كعصف, العصف, he made them like عصف مأكول. He said ورق الزرع الذي لم يقضب واحدته عصفة. He said الورق, which is the leaf of the plants and of the vegetable, the leaves, that it is not like it is not eaten yet, لم يقضب. And then انتهى ما ذكره. وقال حماد بن سلمة عن عاصم بن زرق عن عبد الله أبو سلمة عن عبد الرحمن طيرا أبابيل. Another saying from عبد الرحمن أبو سلمة بن عبد الرحمن, طيرا أبابيل means الفرق. الفرق means the group. The group. فرق group. The same thing, جماعات فرق. وقال ابن عباس والضحاك. ابن عباس أنا الضحاك من التابعين, ابن عباس صحابي رضي الله عنه. He said أبابيل means يتبع بعضها بعضا. طيراً أبابيل, group after group, group following group, doesn't stop, many groups of birds. So throwing stone on them and then comes another group throwing stones. Imagine that. Like you see just small stones coming like rain from the sky. And then he said here, وقال الحسن البصري وقتادة. الحسن البصري from the Tabi'in, he said, الأبابيل, the أبابيل means الكثيرة, a lot, a big number. طيرا أبابيل, bird with a big number. وقال مجاهد أبابيل شتى متتابعة مجتمعة. مجاهد أنه التابعي said أبابيل, they are many and following each other with group. وقال ابن زيد الأبابيل المختلفة تأتي من هنا من ها هنا ومن ها هنا, أتته من كل مكان. So ابن زيد he said الأبابيل they are a different group of birds, متتابعة, following with sequence, one following the other one, they come from here and over there and from there and from here, and he said it came to them from all the sides. وقال الكسائي سمعت بعض النحوي يقول واحد الأبابيل إبيل. Now here, as you say, the saying of these صحابة تابعين or the مفسرين is all like all the same way. Means huge group coming with on sequence like one after the other one and with a big number from all sides. He said وروى ابن جرير عن إسحاق بن حارث ابن نوفل أنه قال في قوله تعالى وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل هي الأقاطيع كالإبل المؤبلة. He said that it is the أقاطيع, which is like group, a big amount of birds which like and like the camel that are like running all together at the same time and furious, being furious. عن ابن عباس وأرسل عليهم طير أبابيل قال لهم, which is ابن عباس, لهم خراطيم كخراطيم الطير. These birds, that's one of the saying of Abdullah ibn Abbas, they have a back like a back of birds. And he said وأكف وأكف كأف كأكف الكلاب, and paws like the dogs, paws like the paws of dogs. So this is the saying of Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه. Also عكرمة, he said طيرا أبابيل كانت طيرا خضرا خرجت من البحر لها رؤوس كرؤوس السباع. He said this bird, special bird, they used to be green, a green bird, it came out from the sea, and he said their head, it looked like the head of lion, like lion, tiger, something like that. Okay, so this is the saying of عكرمة رضي الله عنه. عن عبيد بن عمير طيرا أبابيل, a bird أبابيل, قال هي طيور سود بحرية في مناقيرها وأظافرها الحجارة. He said this is the saying of Ubayd ibn Umair, Tayr al-Ababi. He said, they are birds, black birds, that comes from the sea. In their backs there is, and in their, what do you call it, the nails of the bird.
The claw.
Claw, yeah. In their back and in the claw, there is stones. He said, and Ibn Kathir said, all these chains are authentic. Also, he mentioned عن عبيد بن عمير قال لما أراد الله أن يهلك أصحاب الفيل بعث عليهم طيرا أنشئت من البحر كأمثال القطاطيف كل طير منها يحمل ثلاثة أحجار مزجعة حجرين في رجلين وحجرا في منقاره قال فجاءت حتى صفت على رؤوسهم ثم صاحت وألقت ما في أرجلها ومناقيرها. In this saying, Ubayd ibn Umair, he mentioned the way that these birds throw the stones on these people. He said, when they came over these people, this army of Abraha, so these birds, they shout, sahat, make the sound, and then he throw these stones that were in their back, in their foot. And then he said, ولا يقع على شيء من جسده إلا خرج من الجانب الآخر. And فما يقع حجر على رأس رجل إلا خرج من دبره. Like he said, there is no stones that fell down on the head of someone except if it comes from his body. Comes from top. Now imagine this is like a bullet. You can compare it to a bullet very fast. The bullet, if you touch a human being, it stays inside. This is more than that. It goes through. I think there is some bullet like that. And then he said, ولا يقع على شيء من جسده إلا خرج من جانب آخر. And it doesn't come or touch any part of his body except it goes out from the other side. And then he said, وبعث ريحا شديدة فضرب الحجارة فضربت الحجارة فزادتها شدة فأهلكوا جميعا. And Allah at that time, he sent a strong wind that accelerate the speed of these stones. And then imagine that falling down, and then we do calculation, mathematics, gravity, and so on, and so on. You see the weight of these stones and then speed. The people who want to do calculation, yeah? Allah sent a wind that is very strong. And then it accelerated more the stones to hit these people, and then they were so hard on them, and all of them died. And then he said, Ibn Kathir alayhi rahmatullah, فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ. He said, and he made them like a asf that is being eaten. What does that mean? He said, قَالَ سَعِيدُ بْنُ جُبَيْرٍ. He said, سعيد بن جبير, يعني التبن الذي تسميه العامة هبور, هبور. وفي رواية ابن سعيد, ورق الحنطة. وعنه أيضا العصف التبن. Now a tibn, what is a tibn? It's not the stem of the wheat. It's long. What? That's when it's dry. In Arabic, we call it a tibn. Okay. So the animal, they eat that. When we see all the animals, we see lamb and cow. We give them a tibn to eat. When it becomes dry, it becomes yellow. So he said, a tibn الذي تسمي العامة الهبور وفي رواية عن سعيد ورق الحنطة. And in another narration of from سعيد. He said, "Waraq al-hinta." Al-hinta is the flower. It's the same, okay, like the wheat, but it's called al-hinta. وعنه أيضا العصف التبن. He said, "Al-asf is a tibn. It's the hay." Yeah. والمأكول القصير يجز للدواب للدواب. وكذلك قال الحسن البصري. المأكول, which is al-qasim, that the hay that is made for the animal to eat. وعن ابن عباس العصف القشرة التي على الحبة كالغلاف على الحنطة. العصف, ابن عباس said, it is like the cover of the grain of the wheat. It's that cover, it's called العصف. وقال ابن يزيد العصف ورق الزرع وورق البقل إذا أكلته البهائم فراثته فصار روثا. So that's the saying of ابن زيد. He said, العصف, it is the leaves of the vegetable plants, and also it's the leaves of the kind of onion or whatever what's grown in the ground. When the animal eat it, when the beast eat it, so and then he threw it away, like by digestion, and they make it as a stool. So, and then it became like a stool, a dump. والمعنى أن الله سبحانه وتعالى ابن كثير said the meaning that Allah سبحانه وتعالى he destroyed them and he killed them and then he pushed them away and the evil planning so they didn't get nothing good and then he destroyed them all. No one returned back except the one who tells about their news. Just few of them. وهو جريح and then while he is wounded. As it happened to their Lord, to their King Abraham. فَإِنَّمْ صَدَعَ صَدْرُهُ عَنْ قَلْبِهِ حِينَ وَصَلَ إِلَى بَلَدِهِ صَنْعَى. As we mentioned before, that his heart came out from his chest when he returned to his city, Sana'a, in Yemen. And then he told them about what happened to them, and then he passed away. فَمَلَكَ بَعْدَهُ إِبْنُهُ يَكْسُوبُ. After that, when Abraham passed away, so he mentioned about who took over after Ibrahim from the Abyssinian in Yemen, his son Yakshub, ثم من بعده أخوه مسروق بن إبراهيم. After that, his son or his brother, which is Masruq, the son of Ibrahim, and then after that, one of the Arabs by the name of Sayfu bin Diyazan is a famous one. The people like you know his story. That was before Rasulullah. So he said, Sayf ibn Diyazan has revolution against the colonial, which is the people from Abyssinia. And then he went to Kisra. Kisra, which is in Persia, and the king of Persia. And then he helped him to attack, which is the people of Abyssinia that was ruling Sana'a, Yemen. فَأَنْفَذَ مَعَهُ مِنْ جُوشِهِ فَقَتَلُوا مَعَهُ. And then he sent an army with him, with Sayf ibn Diyazan, and he fought it over the Abyssinian. فَرَدَّ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِمْ مُلْكَهُمْ. On that, their kingdom, they returned back to the tribe of Hamya. Okay, Hamya, which is Sayf ibn Diyazan. وَمَا كَانَ فِي أَبَائِهِمْ مِنَ الْمُلْكِ وَجَاءَتْ وُجُودُ الْعَرَبِ بِالتَّهْمِيَةِ. And then the Arabs, they congratulate Sayf ibn Diyazan after they get back there. What do you call it, the ruling of the land back from the Abyssinian, which is after the death of Ibrahim, and after two successors, after Ibrahim came, and the Arabs, or the Yemeni, at the time, called the Arabs, they get back their land by the help of the king of Persia, Kisra. And then he mentioned Ibn Kathir Ahmad two ahadith, talking about the his relationship with Ashab al-Fil or with Mecca, and Rasul mentioned the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Ibn Kathir, that we mentioned in Tafsir Surat al-Fath that the Messenger of Allah, when he came to the Al-Hudaybiyah, we know all of us, the Muslim, Rasul, he went to do Umrah when the tribe of Quraysh were in Mecca. Okay? And then the Muslim were in Medina. So Rasulullah, he wanted to go for Umrah, and he took the Sahaba with him. So, but now, the Kufar of Quraysh, they stopped them to enter Mecca. And then, other story, it is Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, the Treaty of al-Hudaybiyah. Okay? That's in Surah al-Fath. That's the reason of revelation of Surah al-Fath. He said, عَلَى الثِّنْيَةِ الَّتِي هَبَطْتَهْبَطُ بِيَ عَلَى قُرَيْشِ بَرَكَتْ نَاقَتُهُ. Now, at that location, his camel, the camel of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the she camel, so he went down. He sit on the ground and he doesn't want to stand up and continue. And said, فَزَجَرُوهَا فَأَلَحَّتْ. He said, they were forcing her to stand up, but she insisted to sit. And then he said, فَقَالَ أَوْ قَالَ فَقَالُوا خَلَأَتْ الْقَصْوَىٰ أَيْ حَرَمَتْ. So he said that now the camel, the she camel of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, its name Al-Qaswa, the name of it is Al-Qaswa. He said that haranat, which means like she becomes stubborn, she doesn't want to listen, command the order, the command. And then فَقَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So Rasulullah, he said, مَا خَلَأَتِ الْقَصْوَىٰ وَمَا ذَاكَ لَهَا بِخُلُقٍ. He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like Al-Qaswa, he didn't disobey, he didn't become servant, and it is not the characteristic of that she camel. ولكن حبسها حابس الفيل. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but the one who stopped her, he's the one who stopped the elephant, which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, والذي نفسي بيده لا يسألون يوم خطة يعظمون فيها حرمات الله إلا أجبته إليها ثم زجرها فقامت. So Rasulullah he explained to them that it is Allah who made it stop at that location. That's why he said, حبسها حابس الفيل. The one who stopped that is the one who stopped the elephant. And then he said, by the one who has my soul in his hand. So he will not ask me for any plan that the great, in that plan, the great, the hurumatullah, the house of Allah, hurumatullah, everything that you greet Allah with, except I will respond them positive. Meaning that treaty with the people of Quraysh. And then he said, when Rasulullah he talked to her, so then it moved. Another hadith mentioned about the elephant, in the two authentic Al-Bukhari and Muslim, he said that Rasulullah when he opened Mecca, when he conquered Mecca, he said, إن الله حبس عن مكة كالفيل. He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, that Allah, he stopped, restrained from Mecca the elephant. وسلط عليها رسوله والمؤمنين. And then Allah, now, he made like overcoming the Kaaba, like he put like on the Mecca, like the attacker of Mecca, of course, the conqueror of Mecca, his messenger and the believer. وَإِنَّهُ قَدْ عَادَتْ حُرْمَتُهَا الْيَوْمْكَ حُرْمَتِهَا بِالْأَمْسِ. And her position to be sacred, it became sacred as it used to be before. أَلَا فَلْيُبَلِّغُ الشَّاهِدُ الْغَائِبُ. Indeed, let the one who is witnessing to tell the one who is absent. He said, Ibn Kathir, هَذَا آخِرُ تَفْسِيرُ سُوَةِ الْفِيلِ. So Ibn Kathir said, this is the end of the tafsir of Surah Al-Fil. So inshallah ta'ala we stop here. Next week inshallah ta'ala we talk about tafsir Surah Al-Humaza. Surah Al-Humaza, it is the Surah, it is Makkiya. And then by the number of 9 ayah inshallah ta'ala. We talk about it inshallah ta'ala next week bi idhnillahi ta'ala. So we take a break for 5 minutes and then we continue with the etiquette of taking a shower or a ghusl from Sahih al-Adab Islamiyah, inshallah. Barakallahu fiqh.